YouTube, what is going on? Back with my latest video. Today, I'm going to give you guys an update on the Funko Pop portfolio we did earlier this year and compare it to seeing if Funko Pops are a better investment than the stock market. So let's get right into this video and see how we did with this portfolio. Here we go. Listen, been in the game for a minute, clocking in because it's time to get down to business. Stunting is a habit, on me I'm good at it. Asking around town, I'm known as the Pop Savage. Alright guys, before we get into this video, please smash that like button down below. Let me know you guys are enjoying these videos, and as always, if you're new to this channel, welcome, hit subscribe button down below as well so you're updated to my most recent content, and hit that bell notification so you're alerted as soon as I post a new video. So if it's your first time tuning into this segment I've been doing, what I tried to do earlier this year was see if I invested $1,000 into Funko Pops, would it outpace the stock market, and would it be a good investment in general? And I allowed the community to decide what Funko Pops would go into this portfolio. So today is about 6 months from when we first started, so I thought now was a good time to do an update. And before we get into this, obviously comparing stocks to collectibles is, you know, definitely comparing apples to oranges. It's still a fun experiment to do. So if you're looking into getting into stocks, I'll put a link down in the comment section below. So if you're looking to get a free stock, you can sign up and get one there, because I think you definitely have to diversify and have both. So with that being said, I want to give you guys an update on how we did. And I think now's a good time to do it because we're 6 months out now from starting this portfolio. And also, I just got a package in the mail that's going to allow me to display this portfolio a little bit better. So I got a package today from Vaulted Vinyl. So definitely a huge shout out to them. Give them a follow. They supported the channel in the past with sending out some protectors to myself and some to give away to you guys as well. So they hooked me up with their newest product, which is this display Vault Air, which is a very, very dope product. It's a mountable display that allows you to put up to 9 Funko Pops in there. I gotta find some room in here, and I'm gonna put these Pops from the portfolio in there because we have 8 of them. So I have a 1 empty space, and I'll kind of talk to you guys about what we might do with that moving forward. But definitely shout out to them. It's a really cool product. I will show you guys probably a picture on Instagram of me with the Pops in there because I can't really put it all in the frame right now. And also I don't have space for it in the room at the moment because this wall is full, the wall opposite this is full, and the walls on either side have display cases. So I have to find some space for this, but I think it's a very, very dope thing. And it's a really clean and you know, classy looking display case. So I definitely appreciate you guys sending this out, and I definitely will show you guys how it all looks at the end of this video in an Instagram picture. So without further ado, let's get into the Pops. So like I said, there's 8 Pops that you guys decided that we were gonna add to this portfolio. So I'm gonna give you an update on which each one's worth now, the total amount that is worth in full, and also kind of give you guys a breakdown of how much we made and how much percentage wise that is compared to the stock market. So first up, we got that Freddy Funko Chucky one, the blood splatter one. This one's currently going for a total of $90. So I think that's an increase in value. I didn't write down the increases in value, just kind of the total, because that's all that really is important at this point. But $90 for this one, pretty, pretty cool. So to give you guys a heads up, we spent in total $1,023.50 on all these Funko Pops. So slightly over $1,000, but it kind of needed to be done with shipping costs and stuff like that. Up next, we have the Monkey King Freddy Funko, which I think is still very, very underrated Funko Pop and has a lot of room to go. We have this guy sitting at $65 at the moment. All these prices are based on the Funko app to make it kind of easy and simple for me. They obviously can be a little bit more, a little bit less on eBay or Mercari or whatever at the present moment, but we're gonna go with Funko Pop prices, which is pretty accurate for stuff like this because not as many sell. So it's not really like huge swings one way or the other. With these Pops. So up next we have the Mana guy. I think hopefully I'm pronouncing that right, from the Muppets. This one's pretty cool. He's going for a total of $155 right now, which I think is a lot more than what I spent. So that's definitely a cool one. Up next we have Sloth from the Goonies. Since we got this one into the collection, there has been another one that was released. I was a little bit worried about how the value would be affected. I think it did go slightly down, but it's still going for a total of $190. So nothing too crazy at all. $190 still for a classic character right there. Up next, we have some heavy hitters. We have the Sorcerer Mickey Pop. So this one's currently going for $160, the original one. I think it's the Disney Store one too. So it's probably slightly higher because the Disney Store ones are a little bit more than the non-Disney store ones. But we're just gonna go with the Funko at price, which is $160, so pretty cool value for this. This one I believe did go up in value since, because I think people are starting to realize which ones are real and fake. We have the Scarface Pop, which is $185 on the Funko app. Very, very cool, one of my favorite ones in my collection. Scarface, to me, I know it's typical, but it's just one of my favorite movies of all time. But, up next, we have Emperor Zurg. This one's currently going for a total of $220. So very, very cool pop. Really happy that this was one the community decided on, because it's just a pop I've been looking to add for a very, very long time. And it's just such a cool pop, cool character in Toy Story 2, and you know, definitely a high value pop at the moment. And last but not least, the most expensive pop in the portfolio, and the one that kind of went up the most. And glad we decided to get this one at the time that we did. But we have Speedy Gonzales, which is sitting at a total of $560 right now, which is very, very crazy. We did not pay anywhere near close to that. So definitely one of the big gainers in the portfolio at $560. All right, so like I said, guys, we spent a total of $1,023.50 for this. So definitely a cool, a good total, I would say, because in total, this portfolio is now worth a total of $1,625. So that's about $601.50 increase in value. So last time we did this update, the whole market was kind of going crazy with collectibles. A lot of things were going up in value at a significant rate. So I think that's actually a good sign to see, because most collectibles that increase a lot in value recently, like Pokemon cards, sport cards and stuff, have crashed down in value because I think they were overinflated. You know, a lot of people got hype about them, and they have definitely gone down in value since last time we did an update. Although we only went up in the last 6 months from the last update 4.8%, which I still think is a very, very good total, because everything else in collectible world went down and Funko Pops have remained strong. So in total, from the time we first purchased it was about like six and a half months ago, we have increased in value 58.8%, which is a crazy return on investment. So I just wanted to kind of highlight that, you know, since the crash of collectibles has been taking place, Funko Pops have still gone up in value. And in total for the year, or 6 months, we have 58.8% in total value, which is an absolute crazy return on investment. In 6 months, if you invested $1,000 in the S&P 500, you would have made 10.15% in value. So about $100.15. So a lot different as far as investing in Funko Pops as opposed to stock market. Now, as far as if you want my opinion, because I know a lot of people can ask, I don't think that this is going to remain true for much longer. I don't think this is sustainable. I don't think we did this next year, we would get the same amount of return. But definitely we started this portfolio at the right time, when the collectible boom had not really gotten to the Funko Pops yet, and it seems as though Funko Pops were not as affected as other collectibles were. So we definitely can see, and again in 6 months or however often you guys want to see an update, how Funko Pops do trend with the stock market and it on an even playing field, as far as collectibles aren't skyrocketing. You know, both are kind of, you know, at a normal pace. So moving forward, like I said, we have this display vault air now that we can put the portfolio in, and that is allowing us to have one missing spot. So I'm gonna open the portfolio back up to you guys and see what we want to do now moving forward. I kind of have three ideas as far as what to do. There was one pop that I kind of wanted to look into selling, but I'll leave it up to you guys as far as what we do. I was thinking about selling that sloth pop and adding another pop or two to the portfolio and see how that goes. The other option is just to leave it the way it is. Or the third option is just to fill that space with a new Funko Pop. So I'm gonna open it up in the comment section. I'll put a poll on the community page as well to see what we should do next with this portfolio, and see if we can grow this even further past the $1,000 mark and hopefully get to the $2,000 mark very, very soon. So I think it's a really fun project. I think, you know, investing in Funko Pops is a really cool and fun thing to do, because you are investing and buying what you like, and it's still increasing in value. So I really just wanted to give you guys an update and kind of show you guys proof of concept that you can make money investing in Funko Pops. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below about what we should do moving forward, and let me know how you if you guys are gonna do something like this on your end. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I do appreciate your support as always. Drop down in the comment section below what you should think we should do. Like, comment, share, subscribe if you're new. Check me out on my Instagram at ThePopSavage. You can see me display this display vault air with these Funko Pops in there. And also keep up to date with all the things I have going on. And also check out my second channel at Savage Breaks, where I do Pokemon and sport card openings. Thanks again for watching, guys. And until next time, I'll see you later.